that's a state sponsor of terror, Pakistan, and criticizes India on Kashmir. Also, the abrogation of Article 370, which actually gives more rights to the people of Jammu and Kashmir, and especially those who didn't have any rights in the past. And you have superstar Aamir Khan, who's in the eye of a storm for going to Erdogan's house and meeting the Turkish First Lady. Now, many in India are extremely upset. Aamir Khan is a superstar in our country, and Aamir Khan is with people who are extremely critical of India on Kashmir, on Article 370, and even on Delhi rights.
The actor, who is known to speak his mind, is facing flak for meeting Turkey's First Lady, Amin Erdogan. In the midst of shooting his film in Turkey, Aamir met Turkish First Lady Amin Erdogan at the presidential residence in Istanbul. She later took to social media to share pictures of the meeting and wrote, "I had the great pleasure of meeting Aamir Khan, the world-renowned Indian actor, filmmaker and director in Istanbul." As soon as it became public, the actor began getting trolled for meeting President Erdogan's wife amid a diplomatic unease triggered by Turkey's comments on Kashmir. Besides, Turkey has been backing Pakistan on various issues. There are also reports that radical organizations in Kerala and Kashmir are being funded by Turkish outfits.
Deske celebrities ko bhi deske hiton ko dhyan mein rakhte hue, deski bhavna ko dhyan mein rakhte hue vyavhar karna chahiye. अब जिस प्रकार से ये मीटिंग आ रही है तुर्की के एक टॉप व्यक्ति से, और तुर्की हमारा विरोध कर रहा है, तो निश्चित रूप से ऐसे में देश में तो चर्चाएं होंगी.
द एक्टर हैज अ टेंडेंसी टू ड्रॉ अटेंशन, वेदर इट्स अ पोस्टर लाइक द वन फॉर द मूवी पीके और अ रिमार्क मेड व्हेन द इंटॉलरेंस डिबेट वाज रेजिंग इन 2015.
Kiran and I have lived all our lives in India. For the first time, Kiran says, "Should we move out of India?" Now, that's a disastrous and very big statement for Kiran to make to me. That does indicate that there is a sense of growing disquiet.
कि हम इतने अलग हैं, अलग-अलग प्रांत के लोग, फिर भी हम एक हैं. यही हमारी ताकत है, यही हमारी स्ट्रेंथ है, और इसको हमें बनाए रखना है. तो यही मैं कन्वे करना चाह रहा था उस वक्त.
Now, after his meeting with Turkish First Lady, netizens are also calling for a boycott of Aamir Khan.
At Turkey, President Erdogan is friends with Pakistan's Prime Minister Imran Khan, a country that's a state sponsor of terror. Now, Turkey, Malaysia and Pakistan, they're trying to establish an alternate in the Islamic Caliphate. In fact, even Abhishek Manu Singhvi, Congress Party leader, member of parliament, he said that Erdogan sees himself as a caliph, as a new age caliph. Why would Aamir Khan then be with the Turkish president's family at a time when Turkey has made not one, not two, not three, but multiple statements against India, and Prime Minister Narendra Modi refused to travel to Turkey when Turkey made anti-India statements after the abrogation of Article 370?
Be it on Kashmir, Pakistan state-sponsored terror or Delhi riots, Turkey's President Recep Erdogan, in his desperation to emerge as the alternate Islamic power center, launched one verbal tirade after the other against India. Erdogan sided with Pakistan state-sponsored terror after the abrogation of Article 370 and even raked up the Kashmir issue at the United Nations General Assembly.
One of the problems to which the international community Kashmir fails itilafı. To devote enough attention is the Kashmir conflict, awaiting a solution for 72 years. The stability and prosperity düşünleme. Of South Asia cannot Şu be separated from the Birleşmiş Kashmir Milletler issue. Güvenlik Konseyi'nin, Birleşmiş Milletler'in almış olduğu karara rağmen.
So unhappy was India with Turkey's interference in India's internal affairs that Prime Minister Narendra Modi is said to have said no to a proposed stand-alone summit in Ankara. After the Delhi riots, Erdogan made another anti-India statement, which was criticized by India.
On religious grounds, it supports Pakistan. On Kashmir issue, it supports Pakistan. So there is difference of opinion with regard to perception by India and Turkey. And these are the reasons why Turkey is taking anti-India stand.
India also issued a travel advisory telling Indian tourists to be careful when in Turkey. There was also a downgrading of defense ties between India and Turkey. Turkey's tirade against India is being seen as Erdogan's desire to be seen as a modern-day leader of the Islamic world. In fact, Congress MP Abhishek Manu Singhvi took to Twitter to say how Erdogan's anti-India stance was to be seen as a self-appointed caliph, and Turkey under him was also funding terrorism and extremism in India. Bureau Report, India Today.
Joining me now on the broadcast is Saira Shah Haleem. She's a theatre personality, writer and activist. She defends Amir Khan's trip to Turkey. I have Ambassador Ashok Sajjanhar, someone who understands India-Turkey relations very well, will give us a diplomatic perspective. Raghav Awasthi, what is wrong? You're a lawyer, you're an activist. If Amir Khan visits Turkey, there is no ban on Indians visiting Turkey.
There is no ban on visiting Turkey, but we have to understand that it is symbolism that also matters in public life. Now, Amir Khan is somebody who has made his millions showing his films to an Indian audience, to a predominantly Indian audience. And here you have Erdogan. Everybody in the world knows what sort of antecedents he has. Everybody knows how he has totally eroded and destroyed Atatürk's secular legacy. And the most recent feather in his cap has been when he has converted the Hagia Sophia Cathedral into a mosque. So basically, he is perpetrating the same injustice which was perpetrated hundreds of years ago. So if you pose for a picture with the wife of such a man, then people will also surmise that you are also an Islamist. And if people surmise that you are also an Islamist, then there will be a price to pay at the box office. So he should not complain tomorrow.
Okay, stay with me for a moment. Okay, that's a big threat, a call to boycott his films. But that's a big charge that he's an Islamist if he's standing with the likes of Erdogan and his family. Saira Shah Haleem, respond to these allegations that are being made when Prime Minister Narendra Modi refused to travel to Turkey because of Turkey's anti-India stance on Kashmir and Article 370. Should Amir Khan be seen with the president and his wife? 2017, he got a picture taken with the president. 2020, he's with the wife.
See, I'll like to say one thing to this right-wing brigade, that accepting a social invite is protocol, is grace. And secondly, we need to understand that these people who are trolling him are completely morally bankrupt and mentally challenged, because they need to settle some kind of political scores with Amir Khan, because he made a statement a couple of years ago, and I think he's well within his right. If Raghav believes that we are a theocratic state and Amir Khan, being someone from the minority community, doesn't have the right to even articulate his thoughts that lynchings are happening in the country and the country is becoming safe because religious radicalism has reared its ugly head. So tell me, is he within his right or not to display his fears or he was wrong in doing that? I think we are not a theocratic state like...
Saira, you are silent on the religious radicalism in Turkey. But let me bring in Ambassador. Ambassador Sajjanhar, Prime Minister Narendra Modi refused to go to Turkey after Ankara's statements, or if I may, after President Erdogan's not one but multiple statements against India on Article 370 and on Kashmir. What's wrong if Amir Khan went to that country or met with the president's wife?
No, you see, what Erdogan represents, I'll not say what Turkey represents, but because I think it's really Erdogan and his policies. You know, he's a Wahhabi, he's a fundamentalist. And this is the sort of policies that he's been following. You know, you look at what he has done to the opposition in his country. You know, there was a coup against him in 2016. What did he do? He has bundled up all the intellectuals, all the teachers, all the judges, all the government servants, more than about 80,000 of them. in prisons. And he, of course, you know, in addition to criticizing India, what you mentioned last year, Turkey was the only one, in addition to Mahathir Mohamad at the UN General Assembly, who spoke against India. No other country has spoken against India. So I'm a little sort of, you know, disappointed, I would say, and perplexed as to why did Mr. Amir Khan had to choose Turkey to go and finish the filming of finish the shooting of his film, because there are so many other countries. Why choose Turkey? Because that in itself, in terms of its relations with India and also its safety and security, you know, it's interfering in Libya, it's interfering in Syria, it's interfering everywhere. And there have been sort of bomb blasts that have been going on in Turkey. Why choose that country? Because it doesn't make sense. And then, you know, one last point here, meaning he did not accept an invitation. He actually asked for an invitation to go and meet the wife of President Erdogan. It was not that he was invited to the presidential palace. He asked for that meeting. He went there. And I think being so insensitive to the concerns and to the feelings of the Indian people, I think it doesn't put him in right light, right perspective.
Okay, Raga Bhavasti wants to quickly respond, but I want to quickly bring in Saira. Saira, please comment. Amir Khan, according to Ambassador Sajjanhar, who understands diplomacy much better than all of us here put together, says Amir Khan is being insensitive to Indian concerns and the agony of Indians. Here is a man who's abusing our country, who's abusing us left, right and center at every platform, and Amir Khan is going and meeting those people.
As Sir said, you know, respected ambassador, as he said, that look, it's not about Turkey, it's about Erdogan. So when you're mentioning country, so there's nothing about India. They must have been countries that criticized what was happening. You know, we all know the entire cycle. Why do you think they were, the intelligentsia were all, you know, protesting against the CAA, NRC, 370? It's not only people in Turkey who were contesting whatever is happening, because it was a discriminatory law that was passed. It was against the wishes of the people. So people in a democracy have a right to protest peacefully. Okay. Or you please announce whether we have become a theocratic state. If we are still a democracy, we need to
understand. I think you're digressing. Are you not digressing from the issue? The issue, Raga Bhavasti wants to come back, come to you on this point. Because it's not CAA that we are talking about. We are talking about Article 370 and his criticism of India on Kashmir. On Kashmir, which is an integral part of our country, where your father and my father have served.
That contested 370. There were a lot of political parties as well as student leaders, students who contested this abrogation of 370. You know,
it was an act of parliament. I think you need to read up on an act of parliament where Article 370, where Article 370 was passed by the Indian parliament. That's how democracy functions. But I want to bring in Raghav Avasthi.
It is still being contested. It is still being challenged.
That's for courts to decide and not for Erdogan to decide. Okay, Raga Bhavasti wants to respond to you. Go on, Raga.
Whether a father who served proudly in the Indian olive green uniform, whether he approves of Turkish interference in Kashmir, she should put her hand on her heart. She should put her hand on her heart and say that a father approves of Turkish interference in Kashmir. She should say that. Tonight, she should say that on your show, that her father who donned the olive green and who took a bullet for us, whether he has a father in Kashmir.
I refuse to engage.
Tell us tonight.
Okay.
Please tell us.
I refuse to engage in this frivolous conversation.
Let's stay on facts. Yes. 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 Okay. Okay, I agree. Let's stay on facts. Let's stay on facts. Yes.
Frivolous debate and engagement. I'm sorry. So here you're trying to demonize the person.
Saira, don't get locked up. Saira, point made. Point taken. Let's come back to the substantive point. Raga Bhavasti, let's stick to the substantive point. And the substantive point is, what is wrong? Have we downgraded our ties with Turkey? Have we stopped trading with Turkey? Have we said tourists should not go to Turkey? If not, then why target Amir Khan? Because Saira Shah Haleem says he's being targeted because his name is Khan. And the religion that he follows is Islam.
No, he might not. He might not be a practicing Muslim. He is Muslim enough just to have a Khan in his name. I'm sorry. The way the right wingers are destroying the nation because they're trying to talk about Turkey. What about themselves? What about the right wing tweets that Raghav Avasthi puts out every day on Twitter?
Okay.
Isn't that destroying the fabric of the nation?
I put out that point that you were picking. Raghav Avasthi, please respond.
In that case, Gaurav, don't blame people and they don't want to watch your movie. Because he has made a choice. He is now standing with the wife of somebody who throughout the world, not just when it comes to matters in relation to India, stands for a very specific ideology. What is that ideology? It is Islamism. It is pan-Islamism. It is a revival of the glory days of the Ottoman Caliphate. This is what Erdogan stands for. Everybody knows that. This is not just an Indian concern. This is a concern that is shared by people across the world, including a very prominent section of the left liberal intelligentsia on both sides of the Atlantic.
So I will answer Raghav Avasthi on that. Gaurav, can I answer Raghav, please?
Yes, you can. But before that, I want to bring in Ambassador Sajjanhar. Ambassador Sajjanhar, do you find merit in that argument that if Aamir Khan is with Erdogan in 2017 and Erdogan's wife in 2020 and seeks a meeting and those pictures are put out, there's a signal that is being sent out that he's with somebody who wants to be a caliph and is establishing a caliphate. It could purely be personal decision. You know, it could purely be an economic decision.
Yeah. You know, Gaurav, there are two aspects to it. One is in terms of the international policies that Recep Erdogan is following, which is exactly he wants to become a caliph. He wants to really create an alternative center for the Islamic Ummah. He does not want the leadership of the Saudis. And that is why, you know, he's hobnobbing with Pakistan. He's hobnobbing, trying to hobnob also with Malaysia when Mahathir was there, because he wants to sort of create a space for himself amongst the Muslim nations. He wants to emerge as a caliph, as you said, as Mr. Abhishek Manu Singhvi also said. So I think, you know, what the lady was saying is exactly right. I don't think people in India criticize Mr. Aamir Khan for going to Turkey. No, I think he went to Turkey a couple of days ago. There was no problem with that. The problem is that he has gone and met the wife of this tyrant, of this Wahhabi Islamist, who's sort of, you know, trying to spread this hatred amongst people. And I think that is, and he's trying to spread hatred against India. So both his anti-India policies and the policy in the world, I think both are very undesirable, and that is why people are reacting in the manner in which they are.
Fair enough. I will let that be the last word on the broadcast since I've run out of time on this show. Saira Shah Haleem, Raghav Avasthi and Ambassador Sajjanhar, as always, it's a pleasure to have you on the show. The point that Ambassador Sajjanhar makes is that if someone's known by the company he keeps and if he's in the company of radical Islamists, then perhaps for some people it could be a cause for major concern. But before I let you go, I want to leave you with images of a very dramatic rescue operation that was undertaken by the Indian Air Force. And this was a rescue operation. Take a look at these images. This was a rescue operation that was undertaken in Chhattisgarh. Now, fast-flowing water, a man was trapped. In fact, he hung on to a rock and a tree till the time the Indian Air Force managed to get a helicopter in that area and winch him to safety. So this was the Chhattisgarh police that requisitioned the Air Force, the administration, and brave air warriors who brought in this chopper to rescue the man to safety. I leave you with these images. A quick break. News and updates continue on India Today. Stay with us.
Hello everyone, this is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.